Restored Republic via GCR update as of April 10, 2020. Patience is a virtue. Having virtue is a sign of a good moral being. Good moral beings have the power to overcome evil and change the world. Judy note, today Thursday the 9th of April Fleming, several unrelated bankers, Bruce, Marks and a couple of other significant Intel contacts all agreed that Tier 4B, us, the Internet Group, notification and exchange redemption appointment setting could likely happen Tuesday the 14th of April. Since at least October 2019 the Pentagon Pedophile Task Force had been utilizing thousands of U.S. troops in the rescue of over 35,000 malnourished, caged and tortured children, some deceased, from underground tunnels in Washington, Los Angeles, California, Florida, Dallas, Texas and New York, including an underground tunnel beneath New York Central Park where a medical unit was set up in tents, complete with a large air duct pushing fresh air into the ground. With a large Navy medical ship stocked in both the Los Angeles and New York harbors, we were told that more rescues were coming. C.E. Over 35,000 malnourished, caged children rescued out of U.S. tunnels by military, before it is news.com web link. Over 35,000 malnourished, caged and tortured children have been reported rescued or found deceased in underground tunnels beneath large U.S. cities, including one beneath New York Central Park, with more coming according to reporter Timothy Charles Holmeseth of the Pentagon Pedophile Task Force on the 3rd of April. A worldwide fast and prayer has been called for Good Friday the 10th of April that the global COVID-19 pandemic may be controlled, healthcare givers protected, the economy strengthened, life normalized and as the prophet Isaiah quoted the Lord, to loose the bands of wickedness, to undo heavy burdens and to let the oppressed go free. See the mark here, www.youtube.com web link. A Fleming military intel contact report for Thursday the 9th of April 2020. 1. All was ready for release, but legal and logistical issues came up this morning Thursday the 9th of April, stopping the stimulus bill funds from being released. This has been a deliberate strategy of the deep state to stop POTUS's re-election and keep the economy locked down. 2. Behind the scenes the White Hats were overcoming today's legal and logistical obstacles. Google Dems block McConnell to swiftly approve and commit.pub, 3915. Pelosi holds hostage public aid. 3. Also behind the scenes daily security audits of the military operation was still a high priority to decision makers in the timing release. 4. White hats and decision makers were working around the Democrat deep state blocks in the Senate to release stimulus bill funds into Treasury control for release right now, tonight Thursday the 9th of April. 5. Dubai One intermediary holding account funds have been accessible to the GOVT. Since Monday the 6th of April, but the GOVT, under the Department of Justice and Department of Defense could not release those Dubai One funds until logistical and legal issues had been solved. This was happening today in spite of Democrat resistance in the Senate this morning Thursday the 9th of April. 6. The Department of Justice and Department of Defense needed to release control of stimulus bill funds from Dubai One to the U.S. Treasury and Mnuchin in order to get out Paycheck Protection Program stimulus checks by direct deposits, SBA loans, and start the GCR, RV full release of funds to CMKX and adjudicated settlement accounts. 7. This would start the chain of events leading to Tier 4A, B start next Tuesday the 13th of April. 8. Continued prayers would be appreciated that the Department of Justice and Department of Defense release control of the Dubai One funds to Mnuchin by this evening Thursday the 9th of April with no more Democratic/deep state obstacles. 9. This would start private access to kick off the private side of the 27 programs and would allow the Admiral's group access to funds. The Admiral's trade and paperwork were already done, but had no access to funds until our start of Tier 4B. 10. This would allow the Saint Germain Trust to release and start processing by Easter Sunday the 12th of April. 11. Other programs like adjudicated funds such as CMKX could start right away. 12. For us in Tier 4B it would put us on go for Monday or Tuesday 13-14 April next week. 13. Stimulus bill paycheck protection program loans and stimulus checks, Direct deposits should reach citizens' mailboxes and accounts sometime between now and next Friday, the 17th of April. Pence also said by Friday, the 17th of April. 14. Our guy said stimulus money's release to the public would happen after Tier 4B was started and going into exchanges redemptions next week. The plan was still for those funds to go out to citizens as we were going into exchange next week. 15. The Tier 4B timing of Snake's Wells Fargo banker who trained the exchange center staff in five states, including TX, was that he was somewhat positive that he would have active exchange agents doing business, exchanges, early next week, Monday or Tuesday 13-14 April was his guess. 16. A Contacts Foundation attorney was told to be on standby to come to Reno next week. 17. There would be no email redemptions or online redemption exchanges, only redemptions and exchanges in person at redemption centers. Otherwise, there would be no need for the travel permission document that would be on the safe web for us currency holders to travel to redemption centers during the quarantine. 18. Be aware of deep state scams to get ZIM info and other currency info from currency holders online through emails. You would be a target for scammers who wanted to harvest currency holder and ZIM holder personal info. B. April 8, 2020 Morning Chat with Markts, www.twitch.tv/weblink. My bankers were looking for the reset by Monday, Tuesday 13, the 14th of April. C. April 9, 2020 The Big Call, Bruce, bigcalluniverse.com weblink 712-770-4016 pin 123456 hash. 1. This Sunday the 12th of April would be a turning point for us. 2. Stimulus funding was essentially universal basic income and would never go below the $1,200 per adult and would be direct deposited on Monday the 13th of April. 3. Stimulus checks would come out Thursday the 16th of April. 4. President Trump wants our Tier 4B started by Friday the 17th of April. 5. The bankers were expecting Tier 4B to go by Tuesday or Wednesday 13-14 April. 6. The 3 days of darkness for us were last Sat, Sun, Monday where they adjusted our cell service and web. 7. The elders wanted Trump to acknowledge a return to the gold standard, USTN Treasury note, in a speech. In President Trump's coronavirus update today Thursday the 9th of April he said there would be important announcements tomorrow Friday the 10th of April. There would be additional announcements on Saturday the 11th of April and Sunday the 12th of April. 8. Q has put in a code that there would be a miracle resurrection on Sunday the 12th of April. 9. We were expected to go in Monday or Tuesday 13-14 April. 10. Intermediate funds should start paying out tomorrow for the 10th of April. 11. Redemption centers were prepared to go through Thursday the 21st of April. 12. The general public Tier 5 would go the first week in May 2020. 13. The quantum financial system was fully integrated. Wire transfers of funds would go through in seconds. 14. Early this morning Thursday the 9th of April at 2 a.m. EDT on New York TV they announced an emergency broadcast system alert for Man. The 13th of April. That could be the beginning. D. A call for a worldwide fast on Good Friday the 10th of April. The president of the over 16 million member worldwide Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints has called for all peoples of the world to join together in fast and prayer on Good Friday the 10th of April, that the global COVID-19 pandemic may be controlled, healthcare givers protected, the economy strengthened, life normalized and as the prophet Isaiah quoted the Lord, to loose the bands of wickedness, to undo heavy burdens and to let the oppressed go free. The purpose for this ancient doctrine of fasting and prayer was explained at the mark here, www.youtube.com/weblink. E. Over 35,000 malnourished, caged children rescued out of U.S. tunnels by military, before it is news.com/weblink. Over 35,000 malnourished, caged and tortured children have been reported rescued or found deceased in underground tunnels beneath large U.S. cities including one beneath New York Central Park. With more coming according to reporter Timothy Charles Holmeseth of the Pentagon Pedophile Task Force on the 3rd of April. traumatized children, some of whom have never seen the light of day, pregnant preteens, deformed babies, piles of little corpses whose bodies were apparently used for organ harvesting, children locked in cages, electroshocked and traumatized in order to harvest their blood, adrenochrome for the elites to drink, were being carried out of the tunnels by Marines. Apparently for months a secret U.S. military operation has been sweeping an extensive network of underground tunnels across the U.S. and into Canada and Mexico to rescue thousands of horrifically abused children. Recent operations centered beneath major cities in New York, California, Florida and Washington. Intel video on tunnels, UTA.be web link. Full article, beforeitsnews.com web link chainera.blogspot.com web link. F. Zap. As pro-establishment mouthpieces downplayed the efficacy of hydroxychloroquine to treat COVID-19 as anecdotal with little evidence that the treatment is effective, yet another doctor treating has claimed dramatic improvement in coronavirus patients within hours of taking the anti-malaria drug in combination with two other medications. Los Angeles Dr. Anthony Cardillo says he's seen very promising results when the Trump-touted drug was combined with zinc for severely ill coronavirus patients. www.zerohedge.com web link. G. Senator claimed CDC ordered doctors to falsify death certificates to read COVID-19, beforeitsnews.com web link. Utah nurse whistleblower says we were in the manufactured crisis, patient's cause of death misdiagnosed with COVID-19, medical personnel forced to use equipment that should be discarded, donor services shut down, testing for COVID-19 not uniform. www.youtube.com web link. H. Trump, an FBI informant since 1981. 1. If you accept that Trump has been a very valuable source for the FBI since at least 1981, you can start to see his influence in major FBI/DOD takedowns more clearly. 2. In the early 1990s, the FBI was making a major push against the mob in New York. The Gambino crime family in New York was brought down in 1992. The Mafia Commission between February 25, 1985 and November 19, 1986 broke up the five families. Each of these probes would have relied on valuable source informants, much like the Scafo takedown in 1981. Given the above and the Mafia's power in the construction sector, what are the chances that Donald J. Trump was a valuable source for these investigations? Answer. In my opinion, very high. 3. Who led the Mafia Commission prosecution? Rudy Giuliani. Who led the Gambino prosecution? Robert Mueller, who was USAG for the Dodge Criminal Division between 1990-1993. Who was working for Mueller at Dodge, during this time? Rod Rosenstein. And who was the Deputy Attorney General between May 1990 and 26 November, 1992, before becoming the Attorney General? William Barr. 4. Barr's DAG in the 1990s was George Terwilliger. His son, Zachary, was Grassley's Dodge investigator for judiciary. Zachary Terwilliger then became Rod Rosenstein's chief of staff, before being appointed United States Attorney for the Eastern District of Virginia. Who did Zachary Terwilliger replace in Virginia? Dana Boenty. Ring a bell? Boenty is now the FBI chief legal counsel. 5. Would these men know that Trump has been a long-standing patriot and FBI source, for decades? Answer, yes. Would any of these men work for Trump, if he was the traitor and Russian agent, that leftist journalists have been accusing him of? Answer, no way. 6. Buckle up. The storm is upon us. The stage is set, for Trump's hammer to fall. Quadvum.com web link. www.buzzfeednews.com web link. I. International Child Sex Trafficking. FBI authorized to run 24 child porn websites, reason.com web link. Eyewitness to ritual child killings by Dutch royalty, elites and George Soros, www.youtube.com web link. Anne-Marie van Blijenberg, a key eyewitness to ritual child killings by Dutch royalty and other elites including George Soros. Describe the murders that have occurred since 2004 in Belgium and Holland. This is part one of a four-part statement she made before officers of the International Common Law Court of Justice this past summer, as part of its prosecution of Pope Francis and others for child trafficking and Ninth Circle ritual killings. The other parts of this interview are forthcoming. Recorded live on June 5, 2014 from Holland. See www.itx.org. She stole babies from the poor to give to the rich, nipost.com web link. Royals human hunting parties, thejusticeheroes.wordpress.com web link. Masonic satanic ritual abuse, child sex trafficking. www.bitchute.com web link. Satanic gala with celebrities, www.transformation.dk web link. Up to 150 Saudi royals infected with coronavirus. a.msn.com web link. Could these known pedophiles have taken the adrenochrome tainted with coronavirus? J. Judy note on currency exchange, bond redemption, treat the below as my guess. Official instructions would be available upon RV liquidity release. An hour or so prior to liquidity release, Wells Fargo and HSBC banks would send out over 500,000 emails to currency and bondholders, along with instructions on how to exchange and redeem. That information would also be available on certain websites as below. Dinar Chronicles, www.dinarchronicles.com web link. Dinari Recaps, www.dinarrecaps.com web link. Markts, www.twitch.tv web link. Markts Twitter, m.twitter.com web link. Bruce, bigcooluniverse.com web link. TNT Tony, twitter.com web link. Dinar Detectives, dinardetectives.com. U.S. Zim redemption according to Fleming. The Zim default rate was $11 million per 100 T-Zim note. President Trump gave the banks a list of 250 humanitarian and job creation projects for Zim holders to invest in for higher than default rates on the Zim. The UST expected 90% of Zim holders to take the default Zim rate package and not want to present project ideas for higher Zim rates, while 10% of Zim holders would have their wealth manager and team that they would meet with at a second appointment, pursue higher project Zim rates. It was advised not to be among that 90% that would not pursue the higher Zim rates. Either present your own project, or invest in some of the 250 sanctioned projects that you would be shown in order to get the highest Zim rates. Your private banking team that you would meet with at your second appointment would want you to have higher Zim rates so they could work with more money. If you had less than 1, or up to 9 100 T Zim notes, no specific humanitarian project, and if you choose to invest in some of the list of 250 sanctioned international projects, then at your second appointment your wealth manager and private banking team would be more than happy to ask the US Treasury for a higher Zim rate. If you had 10 or more 100 T-Zim notes and no specific humanitarian project, then the U.S. Treasury has determined that you would have more than enough and would be among the 90% that would take the default Zim rate without investing in the sanctioned 250 international humanitarian projects for higher Zim rates. K nonprofits dedicated to help exploited, abused children and adult abuse survivors. Tim Ballard, the Underground Railroad rescued exploited children. ourrescue.org web link. Kevin Annett, International Tribunal into Crimes of Church and State, ITCS, rescued exploited children and exposed their rape, torture and murder kidnapping rings run by the Vatican. Murderbeatgree.com hiddenfromhistory1@gmail.com. Felicity Lee, Ivory Garden promoted healing techniques for DID survivors, dissociate identity disorder caused by severe abuse during childhood. Dissociative Identity Disorder PTSD.blogspot.com web link www.igdid.com felicityforus2@gmail.com. Neil Brick, Smart published information on the satanic ritual abuse of children and gave healing seminars for ritual abuse survivors and therapists, ritualabuse.us web link smartnews@aol.com. Enough is enough. Enough is Enough Registered is a national bipartisan non-profit organization who has led the fight to make the internet safer for children and families since 1994. EE's efforts were focused on combating internet pornography, child pornography, sexual predation, sex trafficking and cyberbullying by incorporating a three-pronged prevention strategy with shared responsibilities between the public, corporate America and the legal community. Snap, Survivors Network of Those Abused by Priests, www.snapnetwork.org. Caroline Spring, UK, Hope and Healing from Abuse and Association Issues, www.carolinespring.com. info@carolinespring.com. 22 Faces, Inside the Extraordinary Life of Jenny Hill and Her 22 Multiple Personalities, Judy Byington. Warning, Jenny gave a graphic description of being raped, tortured and forced to view a child's sacrifice at the tender age of 5, not unlike sordid experiences of thousands of other child victims of satanic worshippers. Such perpetrator followers of Satan were organized from the U.S. Incorporated CIA, Queen Elizabeth's, Vatican's Ninth Circle child sacrifice cult on down to the Clintons, Hollywood and Pizzagate and local teenage governs. They appeared funded by this same cabal that ran our global monetary system, the very organization that was in the process of being brought down by activation of the global currency reset. It's no wonder that President Trump has stated, "These people are sick." www.youtube.com/link. L. Judy note, I do not now, nor have I ever, received monies for writing my updates and articles. The compensation has been in having outlets to help save the children by exposing truths about the very secretive satanic ritual abuse, pedophilia and child sacrifice that was rampant in our international society. To inquire about our international child abuse recovery, trauma survivors, CARTS, humanitarian program, email, info@22faces.com. The above was a summary of information from the internet. It would be up to the reader to do their own research and decide whether or not it was valid. A thank you to those dedicated and brave intel providers who wished to remain unknown, to humble wild fearer a lady who was adept at exposing the truth, to Brad who did great research and Ken who uncovered almost unlimited intel on pedophilia to help us save the children. Divide they try, fail they will, where we go one we go all. To support POTUS, follow Q, trust plan. Let us thank Q that the reset has finally come to be. I wish you well in your humanitarian efforts and look forward to seeing you on the other side where together, we will make life better for all.